Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. In this video, we will discuss question number 20, chapter 10, straight line miscellaneous exercise. If sum of perpendicular distances of a variable point P of xy from the lines x plus y minus 5 is equal to 0 and 3x minus 2y plus 7 is equal to 0 is always 10, show that P must move on a line. So now here see, they have mentioned about two lines. Let us say that one line is this one with the equation x plus y minus 5 is equal to 0. Another line is this one, 3x minus 2y plus 7 is equal to 0. Now here see, they have mentioned about the line. I am drawing here rough diagram and they have mentioned about one point, that is P of xy. So the sum of perpendicular distances of a variable point P of xy from these two lines is given, that is 10. That means here in these two lines, if we consider any two point and if you find the perpendicular distance between the two lines, then that sum is always is equal to 10. That is, for example, let us say that here one point I have taken, that point is, let us say that point is some P of xy. Now here if I find the distance of this point from this line, that we can find as a perpendicular distance. In the same way, distance of this point from this line, we can draw like this way. So this distance and this distance sum, that is, let us say that this is some d1, this is some d2. So d1 plus d2 is equal to 10. This is given to us. And here they have mentioned that we have to show that the point P must move on a line. That means not only one point, here if we take many points, let us say that I have taken one more point here. Then again I have taken one more point here, like this way I have taken. And then if I find the perpendicular distance here, instead of taking here, I will take like this way, or I will take like this way, or like this way. So now here see, the perpendicular distance is this one. So here also, this distance plus this distance, the length is, sum is 10. Again, if I draw a perpendicular from this point to this, then the sum is 10 here. So like this way. So we have to show that here, the P must move on a line. That means, if I join all these points, then that should form a line. That we have to show. That means P must move on a line means when we join all these points, then we should get a straight line. That means in this case, we have to show that answer is in this form. That is AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. We know that this represents a straight line. So we have to get the answer in the general form of a straight line. So if we get the answer in general form of a straight line, that means that we can say that P must move on a line. So now see here, we know that to find the distance of a point from the line like AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0, we have this formula D is equal to modulus of AX1 plus BY1 plus C divided by square root of A square plus B square. Now in this question they have mentioned about two equations. Let us say that this equation is 1 and this is equation 2. And also they have given that distance between x plus y minus 5 is equal to 0 and the point P of xy. That means suppose if I take this point, then this distance and then this distance, that distance sum is equal to 10. Or if I take this point, then the distance, that is this distance and this distance, that is the this distance and this distance, that sum is equal to 10. That is, that we know, that is given to us. So let us take that as 10. Now here see, we know that both of these are the distances. We are finding here the distance of this point from this line as well as from this line. So here that is nothing but the distance only. So directly we can write here as distance between x plus y minus 5 and the point x comma y. So here in the place of x1 y1, replace xy, and a value is 1 here, b value is 1 here, c is minus 1. Put these values in this formula. Then we get 1 into x plus 1 into y minus 5 divided by square root of 1 square plus 1 square plus modulus of 3 into x plus minus 2y plus 7 divided by 3 square plus minus 2 square is equal to 10. Here almost we get the same equation, that is x plus y minus 5 only. Here also you will get 3x minus 2y plus 7 only, because here they have mentioned about the point coordinate as xy. So that's why whatever input value we have, that is the whatever the equation we have, that answer only we are getting. But in some situations you may get some other answer also. So that's why you need to put the value, you need to substitute the value. Now see here, we have modulus sign, here we have a modulus sign. We have modulus sign both the sides. So what I will do is, I will remove this modulus sign, that we can write this one as plus or minus x plus y minus 5 divided by square root of 2 plus or minus 3x minus 2y plus 7 divided by square root of 13, that is equal to 10. See, whenever we have like two modulus sign, we may have four cases. That is, see, if you have like this way, let us say that you have modulus of A plus modulus of B is equal to K. Now here you want to evaluate this one. If you are removing the modulus sign, then we have four cases. The first case is, see, after removing the modulus sign, we write like this way, plus or minus A plus or minus B is equal to K. In this, again, we have four cases, that is, A is positive, B is positive, means we can write like this way, A plus B is equal to K, then A is negative and then B is negative, then we can write minus A plus minus B is equal to K, then A is negative and B is positive, minus A plus B is equal to K, then A is positive and B is negative, A minus B is equal to K. So here we have four cases, that means we have to simplify by using these four cases. Whereas in some cases, see, we have solved some earlier problems. In that case, we had the value like this way. That is something like, if you have like this way, C is equal to modulus of A. Then you have only two cases, that is C is equal to plus or minus A. But in this case, as we have modulus sign here as well as here, so that's why to simplify this one, you have to consider all the four cases. So now let us consider the first case, case 1. See, here I am taking this value as plus and this value as plus. So x plus y minus 5 divided by square root of 2 plus 3x minus 2y plus 7 divided by square root of 13. That is equal to 10. Now here take the LCM. So this becomes square root of 26. So multiply 13 with this, x into square root of 13 plus y into square root of 13 minus 5 into square root of 13 plus, multiply square root of 2 here, so 3 into square root of 2x minus 2 into square root of 2y plus 7 into square root of 2, that is equal to 10. Next here, bring x term together and y terms together, so we can have root 13 plus 3 square root of 2 together with the x plus root 13 minus 2 square root of 2, that is with the y, plus 7 square root of 2 minus 5 square root of 13, that is divided by square root of 26 is equal to 10. Now here, if you take this square root of 26 to this side, then we have like this way, square root of 13 plus 3 square root of 2x square root of 13 minus 2 square root of 2y plus 7 square root of 2 minus 5 square root of 13 is equal to 10 square root of 26. Or you can bring this value to this side, so we have the final answer. Now see, this particular value is in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. See, here we can take this value as a, then we have ax, then here we can take this value as b, so we have by, then this whole together, these three values you can take as a constant. So now this value is in this form only. So we can say that P must move on a line. But we have solved only here one case. Next here we have to solve the remaining cases. That is for minus minus, minus plus, as well as plus minus. So let us consider the second case. Case 2, minus x plus y minus 5 divided by square root of 2 plus minus 3x minus 2y plus 7 divided by square root of 13 is equal to 10. See, here I have taken both the values as negative, minus and minus. Now see, here you can easily simplify this one actually, instead of writing all these steps. You can take minus sign out. If you take minus sign out, then you get the same value which we have in the case 1. That is nothing but x plus y minus 5 divided by square root of 2 plus 3x minus 2y plus 7 divided by square root of 13. and we have already simplified this answer in the case 1, so that you can directly write here. Then you can apply the negative sign, so that wherever you have minus, there you will get plus. So like that way also you can simplify this one. So let us make the simplification. See here, again I have simplified. I have not simplified by using this method. Again, I have done all the methods here. See, I have taken the LCM here, square root of 2 into square root of 13, that is square root of 26. So that this value becomes, here we have minus sign. So minus x minus y plus y. This is minus 3x plus 2y minus 7. Then this becomes minus x into square root of 13 minus y into square root of 13 plus 5 into square root of 13 minus 3 into square root of x, then 2 into square root of 2y, then minus square root 7 into square root of 2 divided by square root of 26, that is equal to 10. Then this square root of 26 I am taking to this side. So we have the values like this way. Now here take all the x terms together, y terms together. So for that purpose, I'm taking here all the values to the right hand side, so that here minus value becomes plus. So we have here x square root of 13 plus 3 square root of 2 into x. Then y square root of 13 minus 2 square root of 2. From this you can take y out. Then we have this. So now this value is also in the form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. See here we can take this as a, then we have ax, this as b, by, and this these three values as c. Next, the case 3. In the case 3, we take one value as plus, another value as negative, that is x plus y minus 5 divided by square root of 2 plus this I am taking as negative. So minus 3x minus 2y plus 7 divided by square root of 13, that is equal to 10. Now here you take the LCM, that is square root of 26. So we have this value x square root of 13 plus y square root of 13 minus 5 square root of 13 minus 3 square root of x plus 2 square root of 2y minus 7 square root of 2 divided by square root of 26 is equal to 10. Now here multiply this with this and also bring x terms together, y terms together, so that we have here the final answer in this way. And here this is in the form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So this you can take as a, this we can take as b, then we have by, then here these three values you can take as c. Next, the case 4, where here the first value I am taking as minus and the second value I am taking as plus. Again the same method you have to follow. Take the LCM and multiply the values, and then after that multiply this with this, so that you get the answer in this way. Then here we have minus, you can take all these values to this side and group the values, that is bring all the x terms together, y terms together. Then we have final answer square root of 13 minus 3 square root of 2 into x plus square root of 13 plus 2 square root of 2 into y minus 5 square root of 13 minus 7 square root of 2 plus 10 square root of 26 is equal to 0. So now here this particular value is in the form ax plus by plus c only. So now we have considered here 4 cases, and for all the 4 cases we have got this form of value that represent a straight line. That means we can say that the P must move on a line. That means if we consider all the points of P, then that forms a line. Thanks for watching.